Hi all, I'm Ankur Gupta and welcome to Analytics School. Everyone dealing with data in any capacity has to be conversant in both SQL and Python. Most of the organization store the data in relational databases such as Microsoft SQL Server, Oracle, Teradata, and others. And it requires SQL programming to access the database as well as to create the tables and various other operations on the table as well. Most of these operations can be done in Python using Pandas as well. Python has Pandas, which makes data import, manipulation, and working with data very easy. The advantage of Pandas is that you can do data visualization, statistical analysis, and connect with any sort of the data. The purpose of this tutorial is to read dataset from relational databases to Python ecosystem using Pandas and use Pandas functionality to do further analysis. Moreover, this tutorial will be of much use to those who have experience working with SQL but new to Python. So let's start the discussion. The first thing which we need to do is to install a Python package called PYODBC. One can easily install this particular package by using pip, or if you are using Anaconda environment, just like me, I'm using Anaconda, you can install this package by using conda. It's very straightforward. You just Google it and you will find out the code, how to install the package, either by using pip install or conda install. Now, I have already written the code for this particular session. I'm just going to show it to you. It's standard, is pretty straightforward, and that's why I have done it. We are going to call the important packages. We have called pandas, numpy, pyodbc. And there is one more thing which I would like to show you, and that is pyodbc drivers. There is one thing which I would like to suggest. Search for ODBC data source and see what drivers are there. These drivers which you are seeing here, you can see the same driver by calling this method drivers for Python package PyODBC. Another thing which I would like to suggest is just check for that whether SQL Server user DSN has been added or not. If not, just add it. It's very simple. Just follow the instruction. Just look for that how you can add user DSN in ODBC. If it has not been added, then add this SQL Server. But prior to that, you have to install the Microsoft SQL Server on your local machine. Since I am showing it to you on local machine, all these things I need to do it. But if you are using your office machine, all these things will be taken care of. You do not have to worry about it. PyODBC Python package is going to be the bridge between SQL and Python. This makes access easy to ODBC databases. By the way, the full form of ODBC is Open Database Connectivity. And MySQL, MS Access, IBM DB2, Oracle, Microsoft SQL Server, these database management systems are compliant with ODBC. Since I'm currently using Microsoft SQL Server on my local machine, and that is what I'll be using to connect with Python. However, the same code can be used for any other ODBC compliant database, only there can be a slight variation in the code. Now, connection to the SQL Server, there are two types of the connection. One is trusted connection and one is non-trusted connection. Let me tell you what is the difference between the two if you are new to it. So this is my SQL Server. Here you see the authentication, Windows authentication. When we are going to use the Windows authentication, it means we do not have to enter the username and password. In that particular case, it becomes a trusted connection. If I have a SQL Server authentication where I have to enter the login and password, then it becomes a non-trusted connection. In this particular case, we will be using the Windows authentication, the trusted connection for this particular use case. But generally in the organization, you have to enter the username and password, and I'll show you the code for both trusted as well as non-trusted connection. So the first thing what we need to do is we need to establish the connection with the server first, and we will be using pyodbc.connect method for the same. This method need a connection and uses a string as a parameter. The connection string can be defined and declared separately, but in this particular case, I have defined it here itself, but you can define separately, or you can write a function or a class, and accordingly you can use in your use cases. But just since this particular session is for beginners, I just want it to be pretty straightforward, and that's why I'm showing you like this. Now, since this is a trusted connection, I do not have to enter the username or password. But for most of the organization, it is going to be a non-trusted connection, and you have to use these parameters, UID, string connection, and PWD, and you have to enter your username and password to connect with it. Now, there are a few more things which you are seeing here. For the ODBC drivers, you can get the details by using the drivers method. And for server, let me show you again. Here is the server name, ankurkanika-hp/sqlexpress. This is one method to identify the server name. The other method is you can write the code. It's a very simple code. Select @ server name and execute it, and you will find the server name. Another thing which you need to take care of is the database, which is your main database is. So you go to on the left hand side, you can see here databases. And you can see here there are three databases. One is system database snapshot, and the third one is analytics code. So since my tables are which I want to analyze, they lie here in analytics code database, I need to mention analytics code as my database. Since we have made a connection between SQL and Python using PYODBC, now we are going to read SQL dataset using pandas read_sql method. However, there are two additional methods available. One is read_sql_table method. It takes table name as a parameter. Another one is read_sql_query method. It takes SQL query as a parameter. However, we are going to use read_sql method. It is a wrapper function around the two method, which is read_sql_table as well as read_sql_query. And this is the method which I use, and I feel it is very convenient, and that is why I'm going to show you an example of read_sql method only. Now it is pretty straightforward. I have called pandas read_sql method, and then I have passed a SQL query, select star from dbo.orders. Remember, it is going to be passed as a string, and then we have to pass the connection, which is trusted_connection. If you remember, this is the connection which we have made by using PyODBC. Now let's run this code. And you can see here, we have read the data directly from SQL server. And the same way we can, call returns table. I created a data frame called df_returns. And you can see these are the first few records. So in this tutorial, you had seen how to connect the two most powerful data workhorses, SQL and Python. Now you can start using pandas to work upon your data, which rests in SQL databases. Once you brought it in it as a pandas data frame, then you can use all the operation of pandas, many of those that are not available in SQL. So that's it for today. Hope you guys learned something new. In the next session, we are going to learn how to inspect a pandas data frame. Till then, goodbye and take care. Thank you.